Hi everyone. In this video, I want to talk about single reaction systems. First, we'll do a brief summary of what a single reaction system is, and then we'll get into how we evaluate and solve for certain variables within single reaction systems. A single reaction system is where there is only a single active reaction occurring within our reactor. In reality, these systems are not super common, as we typically have side reactions occurring or multiple stages to a reaction. However, they do sometimes occur and are a great introduction to reactions within reactors, and they eventually build up to multi-reaction systems. So, now that we have an idea of what a single reaction system is, let's talk about how we can evaluate the effectiveness of a single reaction system. Single reaction systems are really nice to work with. This is because every time we take a step forward in our reaction, the change in our species is always proportional. For example, if we have the following reaction equation, A plus B produces 2C, then we know for every single A consumed, we will receive 2C out. This is great as it allows us to create relationships between all species in our reaction and the limiting reagent. For example, we can use this information to determine the final amount of a given species. To do this, we must recognize the relationship, which is the change in moles for each species in molar terms over the stoichiometric coefficients. This is a great relationship and is extremely useful. However, we can take this one step further by creating the relationship we talked about earlier. Let's create a relationship between our limiting reactant and all of the species in our reaction. This will allow us to determine the change in moles in all of the components of our reaction with minimal information. So, let's write our formula for conversion that we talked about in the previous video. Just note that I am denoting the limiting reactant by this little L here. We can rearrange the conversion equation and plug that back into equation 1. After a bit of rearranging, we can now find the amount of moles after our reaction for any species in our single reaction system. It is just proportional to the change in the limiting reactant, and this is extremely useful. In the next video, we're going to be applying the equations we learned here to some practical examples, so please check out that video if you want to practice applying these equations. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of single reaction systems. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.